Pigeon sport has changed a lot over the last couple of decades. Although there were always fanciers who took their sport a little more serious than most, we have certainly seen a rise in professionalism. If you want to make it to the top, you have to have your stuff together. In other words, you have to have eye for detail. Each and every aspect of keeping, breeding, training and racing pigeons has to be under 100% control, because if you only have it under control for 95%, the competition will beat you. Secondly, the world of pigeon racing has become a lot more international. The top fanciers these days have many contacts all over the world and make sure their birds are raced not only on their own lofts but on lofts in many countries, both in one loft races and by individual fanciers. This gives them a good idea of the performances of their birds in different types of circumstances and provides them with a whole list of references as proof of the superior quality of their stock. The Koopman lineage is one of the most famous in the world today. This Dutch family has more than 80 years of history in the field of homing pigeons, where the roots were laid down by the patriarch Cornelis. His love for animals and especially for pigeons made him an excellent fancier. Initially, he concentrated his interest on a neighbor's birds, which resulted, years later, in him discovering the phenomenon of racing. Although his father was not enthusiastic at first, Cornelis was given his first loft when he was 12 years old. It was the start of a career to stardom. On January 31, 1938, the day Queen Beatrix of the Netherlands was born, Cornelis met his wife, Jans, whom he married after the end of the war, April 27, 1945. Jans was to become the backbone of the Koopman pigeon family. They had four children, of whom Gerard was the youngest. During the war, all the birds had to be destroyed, but after the war, they created a new law. Cornelis and Jans had an egg business and in 1965. They also established a new company for agricultural products, including cereals, artificial fertilizers, potato seed and other services. The egg business was started by Gerard's parents, but it was the older brother, Jop, who was really in charge. In 1969, he also became the importer of Merriman, a Belgian animal products firm. He probably inherited the commercial instinct of his parents. Through Jop's commercial talent, new business possibilities were discovered. His contacts with Belgium offered Cornelis a totally different perspective on pigeon racing. The Koopman patriarch obtained quality birds from the Merriman Breeding Center and, through son Jop, pigeons from J.H. Amelenhu and Pure Jansen Arendonk birds in his loft. The combination of these two lines, Merriman and Jansen, gave birth to the birds Neat and Fouillou. Both won several championships in 1981. The love for animals that Gerard had inherited from his father and his ambition led him to enjoy his first successes in 1981. Gerard was initially crazy about football, but a meniscus injury made him decide to say goodbye to football and join the Pigeon Guild and, from the beginning, he teamed up with his father Cornelis. Numerous victories were the result until 1997, which gave them their justly deserved worldwide fame. Van Loon connection. Gerard, the youngest son of the Koopman family, was drawn to pigeons and decided to race with his father after suffering an injury that took him out of football. It was his relationship with the great Louis Van Loon de Poppel that soon established Gerard as one of the top pigeon fanciers in his area. Van Loon became Koopman's mentor and best friend, giving him wise advice on racing and pigeon breeding. He also found several pigeons for him to build his own loft. He also accompanied him to the Jansen brothers in Arendonk, where he bought several pigeons. He also bought a male from Mr. J.H. Amelen and together with the Van Loon birds, he formed the basis of the current Koopman lineage, which includes such legendary birds as De Zitter, De Eric and De Beatrix Doffer, among others. The Goudend Wife Pigeon. The Goudend Wife, from the Jansen brothers, is the female with the golden eggs. This pigeon descends from one of the best pairs of the Arendonk brothers. Their union with the birds of Louis Van Loon in Belgium brought a series of offspring worthy of admiration. It is worth noting the incredible relationship that Gerard and Van Loon had. Louis was a close friend of Gerard, becoming Gerard's tutor and teaching him everything he knew about pigeons. In the early 70s in Niedordrecht, a neighboring village to Nieuw Amsterdam, there was a fancier, Herman Amelne, who achieved incredible results with his star pigeon, 48. Gerard did not stop until he was able to acquire this magnificent pigeon from Herman's loft. This pigeon 48 had 75% Jansen blood. This bird was a spectacular racer and an even better breeder. It is for this reason that the pigeon became one of the base birds of the Koopman line. Other birds that Koopman acquired over the years were, among others, Black Power, a cross of Jansen bloodlines by Moilmans and her sister, Black Power Lady. Black Power later became the sire of the wonderful Amour. He also bought the dam of Kleine Dirk and many other dogs with which he built up one of the best lofts in the Netherlands in the 80s and 90s. Until 1997, Cornelis and Gerard Koopman, father and son, formed an almost invincible team. Their pigeons lived in a loft no more than 15 meters long, and the birds returned at such a speed that they could hardly keep time. In 1997, the racers' loft moved to new premises in Ermerveen, and Cornelis, the founding father, left the sport. The breeding stock remained at Nieuw Amsterdam for the first few years, because Cornelis took care of some breeding pairs, with great love and dedication, as always. Gerard soaked up all the knowledge that the great master, Van Loon, offered him as a tutor and friend. Gerard was aware that his way to the top was to talk and listen and follow the advice of the great masters in the sport. He processed the information in his brain and put what he learned into practice for his own colony. That is the great strength of great fanciers. And Gerard wanted to be a great expert, the best of all. In 2010, the patriarch of the Koopman lineage passed away and Gerard was the only one responsible for the loft. Breeding pairs. Three breeding pairs form the lineage of Koopman pigeons, invincible over distances ranging from 100 to 800 kilometers. From 48 by Gouden Dwyf. These two aforementioned pigeons were mated together in 1985 and were an absolute success. The pair produced the famous Zitter or the well-known Beatrix Doffer, which won a lot of prizes including first St. Ghislaine against 10,828 pigeons. Also, birds like Zeno, Olympic bird in Utrecht, the 959 Oringlos, who created a new line of ace pigeons in Germany, are some of the descendants of this pair. The Zitter bird gave Hans Lewis, winner of a first place in Bourges, 700 kilometers, in 1993 against 7,688 pigeons. The most famous son of Hans Lewis is the great Branko, Olympic bird in 1997 in Basel and again sire of the miraculous Zebrin. A daughter of Zebrin is Wonder Lady, winner of a first place in Orleans against 5,163 pigeons. Racket 84 by B85-6294112, Van Loon. Racket 84 is a son of John Racket by 76 from the Jansen brothers. His female, 112, is a direct pigeon by Louis Van Loon. This unique pair produced a lot of spectacular pigeons. As an example, the bird Eric, first in Uden against 15,511 birds, first in Beek against 14,881 pigeons or first in St. Ghislaine against 2,206 birds, among other prizes. Eric is undoubtedly one of the most important pigeons of the current Koopman lineage. He is the sire of De Sultan and the legendary and fabulous Gentil, who represented the Netherlands at the Basel Olympiad in 1997. He is the sire of many world-famous pigeons and the basis of the new Koopman colony. Gentile by Golden Lady, Dirk and Louis van Dyck. Golden Lady is a daughter of the world-famous Cannibal of Dirk and Louis van Dyck. In his mind, Gerard already made the pair and decided to buy this female. In 1998, she was mated to Gentil. Kleine Dirk was born from this union, which meant the beginning of a new era. In the following years, this pair produced a series of amazing racers. The Ermerveen Loft. Gerard dreamt for quite some time of acquiring a farm and configuring it in such a way that it would become the home of his homing pigeons. In the mid-1990s, he found a spectacular site in the village of Ermerveen, very close to Nieuw Amsterdam. After a lot of work, he moved there with his whole family and his pigeons at the end of the 90s. Gerard is an expert in long-distance, one-day races and, With the move, his successes continued unabated. Some of his most important racers in this discipline are Kleine Dirk, Mr. Ermerveen, Judy, Yi Men, Wonder Lady, Annalise, Miss Ermerveen or Vita, among others. Mixtures. Premium Koopman All-in-One Gold Corn Koopman for breeders, which the preparation of the mixture is too complicated or too time-consuming. Bayer's developed the Gold Corn Koopman in collaboration with Gerard KOOPMAN, inflicted its first community development. The Premium Koopman All-in-One Mixture that main course and dessert is one. The Premium Koopman L-in-1 mixture to pass feed all year round, with the same base mix, due to the idea of Gerard, all pigeons every day, developed. Describes Gerard freely and openly as he feeds his pigeons. As required, the Koopman All-in-1 mixture with barley, paddy rice or cleaning mixture is added. The pigeons every day is plenty of food available. During the preparation for short-haul flights, the pigeons have to eat everything before they can get new food. Before flights 300 kilometers, the pigeons are fed twice a day. The food that is left over after a meal is given either to the pigeons' partners or to the summer youngsters. If the pigeons are used for a flight with more than one night stay in the basket, the feed is removed around 10 a.m. on the day of use. If you sit longer in the basket, the feed will stay longer. Both the old and the young pigeons get after each workout a small amount of peanut cheese sheep fat mixture. About 1 teaspoon per pigeon per day. After some time the pigeons know that. So you have an extra stimulus, quickly to step in so that the training rhythm of the other pigeons does not get messed up. The sheep fat must be stored in the freezer as it does not contain any preservatives. Additional peanuts are not given. The all-in-one mix and the peanut cheese sheep fat mix contain enough peanut. The widowers who stay at home to receive their partner receive a mixture of 50% all-in-one and 50% barley. During the molting, care must be taken that the pigeons do not get too fat. In winter, carrots are also mixed with the feed. Pigeons do not like to eat them, but only when the carrots have been eaten is new food given. During breeding, the breeding pigeons are given the peanut cheese sheep fat mixture every 3 days. Thank you for watching. Until next time.